This video is brought to you by Galactic Toys and Collectibles. Shop there for toys that are out of this world. Not a sponsor.
TFA 1024, where your entertainment will be transformed.
Bow weep, grung, weep, nitty bong, my fellow addicts. This is TFA 1024, the Transformers Addict, coming to you with another TFA review. Today, all the way from Michigan, we have our first look at the Transformers Studio Series Deluxe Class number 18, Bumblebee, from Transformers Bumblebee, the brand new movie. So, but before we take a look at the actual figure, take a quick look at the packaging. As you can see, it's your standard Studio Series box. You have a very nice CG render of Bumblebee from Transformers Bumblebee. His name is Bumblebee. He is from Transformers Bumblebee. He's from Studio Series. He's made by Hasbro. He's ages 8 and plus. I guess I can't play this. He's an Autobot. It's from Takara Tomy and Hasbro. He's from the Transformers Generations. He is from a brand. On the side of the box, you have a very nice piece of artwork of Bumblebee holding a boombox, which is pretty cool. Very 80s. And on the back of the box, you have your obligatory product shots and your bio if you want to read it. Big screen inspired, scale, detail, and backdrop. Charlie's Garage. Bumblebee tunes up and lays low in Charlie's Garage. You also have your cross sales of Shadow Raider number 17, number 16, Ratchet, and number 10, Wave 2, Jazz, if you want to do that. And hey, he's an officially licensed Volkswagen. Now taking a look at Bumblebee himself. Bumblebee is molded after an old 1967 Volkswagen VW Beetlebug. And I gotta say, he's honestly really, really well molded. I am very pleased with how this turned out in terms of execution and design. I think this is honestly quite possibly the best Bumblebee figure we've ever gotten. I think what they did with the Volkswagen turned out really nice. I really like how there's a few differences of yellow, similar to how Age of Extinction kind of had that, and I'll see if I can shine a little light on that for you guys. But if you guys can see, on this plastic here near the front fenders and near the back fenders, it's slightly darker in terms of palette, but here it's that bright, vibrant yellow that he has in his promo art. The same kind of goes through here, except that here, for some reason, it's like this limish, greenish yellow, maybe, kind of. It's just weird. He has like a different few palettes of yellow on him, but I don't mind it all that much. He's still a yellow Volkswagen bug, and that's all I really care about. The transformation for this guy is also a little involved. It's pretty much like any other after Dark of the Moon Bumblebee transformation, which I'll get into in a bit, but underside, you know, you can see visible robot syndrome. It's all right there.
Surprise, mother...
You can tell how everything's going to work out. But as you can see, there are some spaces up here on the roof and window section. This side, for some reason, does not like to peg in all that well. I've tried tilting it to try and grab some friction there, but it's not doing it. The back section here on my copy will not fully stay in. Like, it comes undone by itself every now and then. Nothing that can't be fixed with floor polish. But for what it is, he can roll, as rolling things should. So, you know, there's that. In terms of paint and everything, I really like the nice translucent headlights. I think that's very cool. If someone can customize this as Herbie the Love Bug, that would be great. I like the nice little turn signal painted out right here. You actually have, I don't know how well this is going to come across on camera, but you do have that Volkswagen hood piece right there. It's actually molded, so it have like the VW logo right there. Yeah, more of that VW logo in the hubcaps, which is nice. No paint, unfortunately. It's just like a gray plastic, but hey, rims and everything are there, so that's cool. On the back, you have some nice little vented detail for like air conditioning, I guess. You have the trunk section, you have the taillights picked out in a nice red paint, and then you have the back bumper with the little exhaust ports sticking out the back. He looks pretty cool. I like him. I like him a lot. So there you go. Now for quick size comparison, I'm going to try and blow through these as quickly as possible because for you, I got out every single Bumblebee iteration from each movie as I could. So let's go ahead and start off with Studio Series 01, Bumblebee, the 1974 Camaro. Here he is with the 2007 Chevrolet Concept Camaro Bumblebee. Here he is with the Transformers Revenge of the Fallen Deluxe Class Bumblebee, slightly customized. Here he is with the Transformers Dark of the Moon Mech-Tech Deluxe Bumblebee. Here he is with the Transformers Age of Extinction 1967? I don't know. The old Camaro Bumblebee in Age of Extinction. The Camaro SS. I don't know the year for this one. I'm sorry. Here he is with the Transformers Age of Extinction Platinum Edition 2014 Concept Camaro Bumblebee. And finally, here he is with the most recent Bumblebee we've gotten, the Transformers The Last Knight Deluxe Class 2017 Concept Camaro Bumblebee. So now with all those size comparisons out of the way, paint talk and everything out of the way, the only thing we can really do is transform him into a robot. So, let's get him from looking like this to revealing the robot within. And here we have everybody's favorite little yellow cash everybody's favorite adorable little Bumblebee Scout. Yeah, Bumblebee and I have a very mixed relationship. One day I'll love him, one day I'll hate him. It's weird. But anyway, here we have Studio Series number 18, Bumblebee, in his robot mode. And while in the trailer for the Bumblebee movie, you kind of see that he's not entirely accurate. Like, yeah, he has the Volkswagen car chest, he has the wheels on his back, but he also has door wings. And I know that the door wings kind of shrunk in robot mode, but here they're just kind of sticking out, and I can understand why. You know, I'm not an accuracy nut when it comes to Bumblebee. First off, I really like this design. I was very skeptical about it. But after now having it in hand, it's honestly a really, really good design. And I personally think it's one of my favorite Bumblebee figures of all time. But honestly, you know, there are its flaws. Like, for example, during transformation, as I mentioned, there are some issues with it. Things when completely tabbed together. Sometimes things were a little too tight, like these front wheels, on my copy, they're extremely tight, and I feel like if I put enough stress on it, those are gonna break off, and I really hope that's not the case. So whenever you do that, just in case your copy suffers as well, just bend them outward very slowly, because on mine, they're extremely tight. As you can see, like I said, you see how Bumblebee pretty much looks. I mean, you know, not size comparison, but for a good example, here is Studio Series 01 Bumblebee, and you can pretty much see the only difference is from the lower body to the feet. You know, everything else transforms exactly the same as you think it would, except a little bit of this as well. So this is still the front of the Volkswagen bug, but this is on a joint to where it's like you can rotate it. So while these are facing up, there's a joint to rotate it downward. On this, it's just a complete hinge, so I guess it's kind of the same. These are just two separate pieces that just kind of peg in together in the chest, and it works. Now, I did fail to mention, before I moved on from the vehicle mode, he does have weapon storage in his vehicle mode, as you guys saw. There's a port right there in his crotch where this gun, or it's on his back. There's a tab near his butt right there, a gray tab. You can peg in his gun that he has in the movie that kind of drops out after Charlie's examining him. He also has a sword that you saw that was pegged into his arm during the review, as well as during the stop motion. And then, if you also notice in the front bumper, you have his battle mask. And you can use these in robot mode for Bumblebee. So, you know, it's basically a double clip connection here. So all you have to do is just line it up. Very nice, like. And now Bumblebee has a blade. Articulation is your standard Bumblebee articulation. His head can rotate, arms can rotate, legs can move forward, back, in and out, swivel a little bit everywhere. I think the only thing that isn't articulated is his feet. But everything else is pretty articulated. You can even emote him with his door wings, which is kind of cute. So, there you have that. And much like every single Studio Series figure, he does come with a backdrop. And yes, I actually did switch out the weapons and everything, and it wasn't as scary as I thought. Guess I'm just a big old coward. But he does look really good with them. The arm transformation for the gun, by the way, is a lot easier and a lot more fun than the SS-01 Bumblebee, because that one's so flimsy, and a lot more fun than the TLK Bumblebee, as opposed to having a mushroom peg. This is just a simple hexagonal peg to port connection. The battle mask, all you have to do is pop off the head, switch out the mask, and then obviously, you already saw the blade in action. So, there we go. So let's go ahead and wrap up this video review, shall we? I think, overall, Bumblebee is actually a really solid figure. As I mentioned previously, when he was in Volkswagen mode, yeah, he did have a little bit of compromises, like things wouldn't go together all too well, but I think over time, maybe the connection might get better, considering this is, like, fresh off the market. This isn't even supposed to be out yet, by the way. This is supposed to be out, along with Shadow Raider and Ratchet, on September 28th. I called Galactic Toys, because, as I said, I ordered this guy, for about $30, and then he still had Shadow Raider and Ratchet, and I was trying to get all three of them. And he cut me a deal, and I paid, $25 for Shadow Raider and Ratchet. Because, yes, I've been saving my money. Good God! So, you know, so I got all three of them. Shadow Raider will be reviewed, honestly, next, and I think I'll save Ratchet for last. And we'll probably go through the rest of the Studio Series toy line, and I'll share my thoughts on those. But as I said before, Shadow Raider and Ratchet will be treated as separate figures, and then I'll go more in depth with the regular Ratchet and the Lockdown. But one more thing I forgot to mention, just, you know, he does actually have feet articulation, you know, pivots, and I think they also move up and down because you see a hinge right there, so sorry. Articulation isn't really my thing. And then here he is next to Evasion Mode Optimus Prime. If you can see him all that well, there you go. Hello, Prime. Overall, I really do enjoy number 18, Bumblebee. I think he is one of the better of the Bumblebees. I am extremely pleased with how well he turned out, and I look forward to getting the Dropkick very, very soon. And I really hope we get a Shatter and a Blitzwing. Please, Hasbro, don't do this to us. Keep Studio Series alive! So, but anyway, my fellow addicts, that's pretty much all there is to say. So if you happen to want this figure, by all means, feel free to pick him up. Head on over to Galactic Toys. He should still be in stock. And if you can't get him now, wait until September 28th and definitely pick him up, because while he's not a necessity to your collection, he is a very nice addition as well as a very fun figure. So pick him up if you wish to do so. Well, with all that being said, my fellow addicts, this has been the video review for the Transformers Studio Series number 18, Transformers Bumblebee Bumblebee. And I'd like to thank all of you for watching. And please remember, my fellow addicts, until next time, to get addicted, stay addicted, and TF Addicts for life! This is TFA 1024, the Transformers Addict. Roll it out! Tell all of one. Not sure if Lockdown, Hot Rod, or an excuse for a repaint. See you next time!